Horvat banks it to himself off the back of the net. Came to Hoglander, put it in front, and shoveled to the corner by Forbort. Hoglander hits Forbort. Edler works to keep the puck in. Forbort's complaining about hitting the head by Nils Hoglander. And now he goes back in with a couple of cross checks. And another one sending to the ice. Welcome Edmonton after that.
Well, here's the hit, and you can see Forbort thought that that was high, so what's he do? A little cross check. No penalties called either way. Penalties are two each.
Hoglander again. He's going to draw a penalty. Gives the puck up immediately. And now Forbort's after him again. Still mad about that headshot that he purported was a headshot, and it's a dogpile in the Winnipeg zone.
Well, and now you talked about maybe bad feelings for Sunday. Forbort did not like that hit, and you saw the cross checks. The referees decided to ignore both.
Vertanen's got the gloves off
with Pionk. Here comes Adam Lowry over.
Now, does Forbort risk an instigator here late in the game?
Yes.
Which could cost his coach. Myers is underneath Appleton and still trying to get at Derek Forbort, who went after the Canuck rookie who a couple of shifts ago hit Forbort with a check that he didn't like, came back with a series of cross checks, and now with a 2-0 lead, trying for a little extra frontier justice.
Well, we saw the referee's arm up. There was going to be a penalty first. Derek Forbort, 6'4", 220. So we can see the size mismatch. It was Hoglander, 5'9", 185. And there's Forbort going after Hoglander. There was no doubt who was the instigator in that, but will the referees call an instigator penalty? You can bet the Canucks will remember this, though.
48 hours from now?
Yes.